We turn the calendar to 2021. We also leave behind one of the deadliest years in Cincinnati history.
We all need to be able to live in safe places, and our kids should be able to go to school without getting shot for carrying a book bag or get hit with a stray bullet.
Cincinnati police investigated 92 homicides in 2020, according to the department's latest report. But anti-gun violence leaders say they remain hopeful 2021 will be a safer year within the city limits. WCPO 9 News reporter Jake Ryle spoke with activists, and he's also breaking down the numbers behind last year's violence.
Deadly shootings in the city of Cincinnati have been on the upward trend for the past 3 years. And activists I had a chance to speak with say they're doing everything they can to try to curb that trend, but they still need help.
August 16th, 2020. 19 people shot, 4 dead within the city limits.
Horrific and tragic that we have this much violence and potential for that much loss of life in our city.
11 people killed by gun violence in August alone. It was the deadliest month in the city in 5 years.
It's a red alert. We have to try to stop our babies from getting caught up in this type of nonsense.
It's easy to get lost in the numbers, but for Cincinnati Works Phoenix program worker Mitch Morris, each statistic is a story.
Each one of the people that you speak about has a family, a mother, father, kids.
The breakdown is trending in the wrong direction. In 2018, there were 51 deadly shootings. 2019, that number was 59. And last year, 85 people were shot and killed. 90% of the shooting victims last year in the city were black, and 85% of the victims were male. Overall, the West End and Over the Rhine were the two neighborhoods that saw the most reported shootings. All of these numbers, Morris says, represents work that's needed to save lives and protect neighborhoods.
We want to take opportunities to meet people where they're at and show them something different, that the way to deal with a situation is not to pull a gun and start shooting for some unnecessary reason.
But a silver lining, gun recoveries by Cincinnati police were up in every district, including doubling the number of recovered guns in District 2 year over year. Morris says creating a safer city is all about changing the mindset of those at highest risk.
We got to try to cut into the way that you're thinking and where your heart is at.
So what does 2021 have in store? Morris is hopeful for continued action at the city level and for folks to rally to say enough is enough.
You got a lot of good people in this city that want to put in and try to help. Just a matter of connecting the bridges and get people to work together.
Jake Ryle, WCPO 9 News.